We're in.
We're on.
Okay, we're on. So, the first question, thanks for coming everyone. The first question I wanted to ask you all today was about project initiation and documentation and the things that we need to create a project charter, the documents we need to create or have to create a project charter. So, I will write my first one.
The documents for a charter. Case study?
Mm-hmm. Well, that's for the city of Rockingham. Okay.
And Ramal, that's a charter.
So the charter.
So we start with the case study, or we'll make our own.
So, yeah, it's. So now all of the things that are relevant to making a project charter, and you can talk about, yeah.
So this is like the plans?
Yep.
So we're at the plan. Yeah. Plan. Mm-hmm. Okay. Does that case study include feasibility study?
No, it was a feasibility study.
That yep. Part of that.
So it's kind of just all information.
Yeah. Okay. I would say business case.
Environmental stuff.
Yeah.
Is that?
Yeah, if there's any like native wildlife to be aware of.
Yeah, it's any restrictions.
Or,
yeah. But it's exactly what we're doing in the environment.
Relationship to start the project. See this, how relevant this project is to the city strategy project.
Yes, yep.
Relevant.
Feasibility covers a lot of things, right? Like, would that be like resource and contractor availability and stuff? Is that part of feasibility?
I would think so, but Kamal might have more.
Feasibility study, we get to the beginning of the feasibility study, before you start, and then you got public aspiration or aspiration, desire, they want something.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Okay. Is that feasible? Is that possible? Can we do that?
Yeah.
Then you someone will do the study.
Mm-hmm.
What we need to do that? Is it possible to achieve these needs? That's the first thing. The first is the aspiration or the goal, what they want, and the feasibility study. Once you do that, the feasibility study basically include everything, including the cost, and how much going to cost. Is it possible to do it?
Yes.
Is there any constraint?
Yes.
Do this project.
Yeah.
That's basically what it involves.
Mm-hmm.
And the costing, who we're going to contact, what we're going to do, and all sort of, all the, at a higher level, all the major component of the project will be listed at a higher level. And then once that becomes the project, then you study those components in detail.
Mm-hmm.
That's it involves a lot of things. That's the right at the start of the project. Just, okay, when it becomes visible, all right, you give it a ticket, then proceed with that.
this is where the procurement risk stuff.
Yep.
Procurement risk.
To a bracket of costs to expect when you write the request for quote or the request for tender, RFQ or RFT. In this instance, 165,000. It would have to be a request for tender.
So I just take that as any sort of project. Sit ourselves in the budget.
Yeah.
We just put everything, whatever is needed.
What about the time estimate?
Time frame. I'll just give it up. I signed up, we'll get a time, just say all that, then we assign, a PM.
Yep.
Project manager who's going to manage all that.
Okay, so I think we've looked at a lot of points, or a lot of project initiation documentation that allows us to create the project charter. So we have completed task one.
Okay, great. Okay. Do we need to put out
task one?
Yeah, task one. We'll take a photo, upload this video.
Yeah.
And they're not, unless we can.